Hello. Hello, this is Sophie Lawson from sophielawson.com, and this is another click-click video where we quickly look at various art books. And today we're going to be looking at these two little books. This one's going to be about this book, Cartoon Animation. And then next week's will be about this one, Compendium of Drawing Techniques. Really excited for these two. I think these two are going to be different to the normal books I look at. I don't know nothing about these, to be honest, but this one here, it actually got recommended by Jake Parker. It's on Jake Parker's recommended book list. So he thinks it's really good. It's called Cartoon Animation by Preston Blair. What do I think about the cover? I like the colours. Well, actually, do I like the colours? No, I don't think I do. Don't think I like the colours. It's a bit sort of... What do I think about that? I love the little characters, and I love the expressions and the emotions, and yeah, there's lots of energy in these little characters. I'm not very keen on the background there. I think I would have gone with a pure white or pure colour. But let's get into this one. Little Ollie the Owl's here with us today. I love little Ollie, he's quite funny. He doesn't get much action, I don't think. I like his little hands. He's going to open this one first, look. Doing little, see? That looks better to me. That would make a much better cover than that. That's what I think. Let's see what we've got going on here, though. Because I love looking at those. It reminded me a little bit, actually, of Dean Yeagle. Because the characters have got a lot of energy in them. Which I love that. So hopefully this will be fun. There he is, look. Little Preston. What date was this made in, I wonder? Oh, look. Preston died in April 1995 at the age of 85. So he's no longer with us. But this book, we've got five chapters. Well, we've got introduction, character development, character movement. That's going to be good. Animation, dialogue, and technical. Technical. Look at him, look. He's quite funny. Introduction. This book is dedicated to Hope and Ian, my wife and my son. I've got a really sore throat today. I'm just going to cough. That's it. Feels better now. If you've ever watched, there's a TV show called The Fast Show. There's a bloke on that who always had a frog in his throat, and he always used to cough. But it's funny, because he'd be looking out for badgers or something, and he'd be there for hours waiting for these badgers to come out. And the moment the badger come out of the hole, he'd start coughing. And the it was funny. I like that lion, look. I like that. Very rough. Yeah, I like that. Character. Oh, this is good. Oh, cool. Look at this, look. Yeah, I like that. See, you've got the big bastard basic shapes, and you've also got the line of action, the gesture. Yeah, the line of action. This is cool. Cartoon construction. Oh, this is brilliant. I love little things like this, little sketchy things. These would be brilliant to copy. Really nice fun shapes as well, look. Yeah, nice big fun shapes. What does it say here, look? Study these drawings. Visualise all forms as solid masses with three dimensions. Oh, I love the energy in these characters. This is brilliant. This is cool. Little Mickey Mouse look. Oh, cool, I like this. Oh, I love this. Look at this, look. These are brilliant characters. Tom and Jerry. That's amazing. That one almost looks like he's moving, like rubbing his hands. It's cool. Got the head, egghead. Egghead. Me and my sister used to say that when we were little. We used to call each other eggheads. Look at that, look, you got the egg, and the egg can be turned into any creature or character. Just a basic egg. He looks a bit like an egg, doesn't he? Look, big egg. Ollie the egg. Oh, I love the shapes going on in here. More head constructions. Yeah, look at this, look. Different types of expressions. This is absolutely brilliant. I had no idea what this book was going to be, and I was a little bit afraid it was going to be just pages and pages of text. But it's pages of sketches, which I love. So I'm going to go through the hands. Oh, I hope he does eyes. Please do the eyes, because... Look, it's just simple little shapes. It's amazing. Little simple shape. Become anything. The cute character. I like that one. These are really nice little characters. That look. Oh, cute kitten. Doggy, I love this doggy. Look, really nice shape. Yeah, big round shapes, like sort of squidgy. Look, it actually goes through the, each thing has got a number, and each draw a line of action to establish the general stance of the figure. Add rounded masses for the head and the body, so building it up. Oh. I'm going to have to look into this artist, Preston Blair. I wonder what they were doing. What sort of thing they were doing. They've got a little carrot. He's drawn that. Yeah, I like that. Doing what Bert Dodgson said, drawing through. Look at all these squirrels. If you want to study characters in different poses and stuff, this book's brilliant. A little bit of colour. No, I prefer them like sketches, I think. He's a funny one, look. Get him, look. He's got a lot of attitude, that one. I like him. They're fun little characters here. It's a bit like, Oh, who is it? There's an advert with a character like that. The Screwball. Goofy characters. Goo-hoo! Goo-hoo-hoo! Yeah, I don't like characters like that. Big fat things. Aggressive. He's quite cool. Even though he's a bit like aggressive, he's quite a fun one. These enough remind me of Disney characters. Sort of, I'm wondering whether he worked for like famous cartoons or something. I wonder if there's a bit about him in the start. Preston Blair, yeah, look, Preston was one of the first fine artists with the Disney studio. He designed and animated the hippos in the dance of the and Mickey Mouse. He did Pinocchio, Bambi, then he went over to Barney Bear, Flintstones, bloody hell, he did proper cartoons and stuff. Wolf heads. Little wolves. These are some of the funniest characters. Oh, look at that. Look at the shapes between the shapes. I like these little birds. Boing! Yay! Look, little Ollie's friend. Little Ollie. Ollie's little owl friends. Don't be horrible. More. Oh, I love that. Little penguin, look. Love that. That's Thingy, isn't it? Off of, what's it, Roadrunner? Looked a bit like him. Bulldogs. Sailor. Little sailors. Foreshortening in perspective. Going up, talking about perspective, look. Little gnomes. I wonder if gnomes are fun, or I sometimes feel like gnomes would be actually a little bit evil, pretending to be fun but actually evil. Little dwarfs. I don't like those elves. Wicked witches. I like her shoes. Little kids. Oh, I prefer animals. They're a little bit like Snoopy. The characters from Snoopy. Young heroine. That's a nice pose. Oh, look at that pose as well. La di da, character movement. Line of action. Look at that. Oh, I like that. It's showing you how to do it wrong, how to do it right. Yeah, you want simple. This is amazing. Rhythm in design and cartoon art. Oh, that's cool. Look. These would be brilliant to study as well, like copy. Bouncing ball. Who was it talked about that? I think it was Proko. Proko was talking about that. He spent ages animating a Stan Prokopenko from Proko. He said about he spent ages animating a bouncing ball. Because if you can animate a bouncing ball, God, there's just some. It's cool. The difference between walking and running. There's so many images in here. Oh, I like that scroll. Oh, I know what it is. Caramac. No, caramel. Cadbury's caramel. Cadbury's caramel has a character like that. I would have given her longer legs. I think her legs are a little bit too short. I like the shape there. Four-legged animals. Construction and movement. Oh, I like that. Look, simplified it. Interesting, this is flight of birds. Funny. Oh, that little kitty, look. Dun 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 dun. Animation. How to animate film cartoons. Little Ripper. Even these little, like, sort of stickmen things are full of life. It's insane. Look at that one. Look how much energy is in that. I'm very impressed with this book. Action and reaction. Look, big dog there. Oh, cool, look, it's him. That's quite fun. Insane. Multiple action paths. See, I need to read that to understand what's going on there. The wave principle. Oh, like ocean waves. The line of beauty curve. Yeah, so you're sort of taking things from nature. That's the thing, nature does it perfectly. Oh, these are lovely shapes. Again, that's like Roadrunner. Surprise reaction. Oh, I like him. I think he's my favourite character. What's this here? Look, I've got a little, bookmark. That's quite nice, isn't it? Black Wells. I like that, it's like an old-fashioned little bookmark thing. Got his hand in his pocket. Overlapping action, following through. Need to read it. The dancing hippo. I'd love to see one of these taken right through to the end. To see what he would do. I reckon these are actually scenes from an animation that he actually did, I reckon. Disney, yeah, it's probably from a Disney film. So you could probably, I bet you could find this little snippet of an animation, watch it, and then you could come in here and actually look at it frame by frame sort of thing. Almost like going in reverse. Oh, these are nice. Got a sort of retro vibe about them. Sexy. Look at that. Pointy as well. Like that. Bit of pointy with the curves. Oh, look at these feet. I got a thing for feet. Look. Dean Yeagle does the best feet. But those are up there as well, I think. Building an action. A dance kick. Again, you can really feel the energy in these characters. Oh, that's nice. A bit different, isn't it? Ah. That'd make a nice tattoo or something. Composition. You can draw, why not try? Dialogue. Talking. It's all about the story. How are you going to get the story out with pictures? Yeah, you can definitely see sort of Fred Flintstone in that. I can sort of see Freddy Flintstone. Oh, look. How to draw certain letters and stuff. This is brilliant. Hello. Hello. It. That's cool. Mouth action. God, this is very in depth. The heckler. Don't like that character. He's a bit, I was gonna say he's a bit of a knobhead. A little bit of a knobhead. Technical. Here we go, look. A little bit of theory. Yeah, I thought the whole thing was gonna be like this. But oh, look at this, look. This is like the storyboard. You've got the storyboard, the actual story. Unbelievable. Yeah, storyboard and the script. And then put it all together. This is like behind the scenes of an animation master. I wonder what that's all about. Cutouts. Maybe what they do is, yeah, maybe what they do is, if they need to change the face, they keep the rest of it, but they just keep changing the face, but they keep the body. Ah! So what they do is, they must be sort of using the character as segments. A bit like how you do, I used to do programming at university when I was younger. And what you did was, you had like little functions. So each function did a certain job. So what you could do was, one of the functions might be move a finger, and then another function might be stick your finger up. But what you could do was, you could use that function for a different character. A bit like that, you're reusing the same things. That's what it feels like to me. He's cool. Oh, I like this one. God, look at that, look. I love stuff like that. Well, I can definitely see why Jake Parker recommended this book. It's amazing. It's all going into, look. What's that called? The thingy-majig. That looks a bit like the golden ratio thing. Photocopy. Camera. Camera action. How cartoons are made. Pointers on animation. I wonder if they still use these techniques nowadays with everything going digital. And look how it ends. It says, my sincere best wishes to you. That's a nice way to end it. Other books about animation. Got a bunch of books there. And we finish with this. And there he is, look. Little Preston, a legendary figure in the world of cartoon animation. A legend. Well, I loved that. That was absolutely... That was probably one of the best surprises I've had in a long time. Because I've got to be honest, I had no idea whether I was going to like this book. It's brilliant. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you later for another one.